Hello everybody, and welcome to MATH-segnale. As mathematicians, we think that there's nothing more amazing than a problem set in a specific area of mathematics, but whose solution is hidden in a completely unrelated one. In this case, you have to build a link between them if you want to start this wonderful journey. Today, we are going to talk about dice, regular dice. So if you roll one of them, you can obtain numbers from 1 to 6 with the same probability. But what if you roll two dice and you add up the results? Well, you can obtain every number from 2 to 12, but they're not equally probable. For instance, if you want to get 2, you need a 1 on the first die and another one on the second die. The same holds for 12. But if you want to get 7, you have much more possibilities. For instance, you could have 1 on the first die and 6, or 2 and 5, 3 and 4. Or you can switch the roll of the two dice and you get 6 chances. So once you know that the probability of a single event is 1 over 36, you can calculate the probability of every result. Well, now we can start with the problem.
The problem of today is about rolling two dice and summing the results together. You can think, for instance, you are playing at a board game, like Settlers of Catan. The things we want to change are the numbers on the sides of the dice. Here is the problem. Can we find two other dice such that when you roll them and when you add them together, you still get the number from 2 to 12 with exactly these frequencies? A positive answer to this problem would be incredible. You could go to the house of your friend, which is a professional Catan player, and tell him, "Wait, don't roll them. Use my special dice instead." And he will probably reply something like,
"Oh, come on, man! They are completely different! They don't even have the same numbers printed on! How could you think they could generate the same distribution?"
And you can answer, "It's strange, I know, but if you sum the results, my dice are a perfect replacement of your dice." That's crazy. A possibility of finding a solution is to go by trials and errors. We will use these pictures to represent our dice, and let's choose two completely random dice. You see? Repeated numbers, numbers bigger than 6, even the number 0. We compute the frequencies by going through all the possible combinations, and we get a diagram like this. So let's check. There is only one possibility to get 3, which is 3. Plus 0, and there are 3 possibilities to get 10. One is 4 plus 6, and the other two are 9 plus 1, since there are 2 ones on the second die. It's clear that this is not a solution. If you compare the diagrams, you see that there are numbers which are not in the original diagram, and even the same numbers have different frequencies. So we will discard these dice and try lots and lots of other combinations until we possibly find the correct solution. Today, we will not only show you that the answer to this problem is yes, but we will show you also a very clever method to get the answer and much more. So stay tuned! The secret is a link between two apparently different topics of mathematics. Did you know that it's possible to associate a die with a polynomial? Let's do an example with our normal die. This is the polynomial associated with it. The exponents correspond to the numbers on the die, while the coefficients count how many times does a specific face appear. So let's do another example. This is the die. This is the associated polynomial, and you see there is the zero face, and there are two threes, so we have 2 times x to the third. The problem is, why are we doing that? Well, at the beginning, we took two normal dice, rolled them, and we take the sum of the results. So let's take the corresponding polynomial and let's multiply them together. This is the result. And did you notice something? This new polynomial describes exactly the table of frequencies we were looking for. Is this a coincidence? Well, let's try with the other example we did. So, these are the two dice. These are the corresponding polynomial. Let's multiply them together. We get this. And yes, they are the same. The reason for that is that the way in which you multiply two polynomials together is exactly the way in which you count all the possible pairs in the sum. And so, for instance, we have 1, 3 here, which came from x to the third times 1, and we have 3 possibilities to get 10. One is x to the 4th times x to the 6th, and the other two come from x to the 9 times 2x. And this is the secret we will use to solve our problem.
Let's try to formulate our original problem, but this time in terms of polynomials. So we add our two dice, and so these polynomials, and when we multiply them, we obtain this polynomial which represents the distribution of the sum of our two original dice. Our aim is to construct two other dice, and so two other polynomials, such that when we multiply them, we will obtain the same result as before. But how can we do that? Well, when you have a polynomial, you can try to factor it, as you factor numbers. For instance, 12 is 4 times 3 or 6 times 2. And if you factor our polynomial, you'll get this. Those are all the terms you can try to multiply by each other in order to obtain your new dice. For instance, in this way, you'll get exactly our original dice. And so you can say, well, choose another way, randomly, and you get your new dice. Not yet, since we have some constraint. For instance, since the coefficients mean the number of faces with a certain value, you'll need only positive integer coefficients. And since we are interested only in six-sided dice, the sum of all the coefficients must be 6. Nevertheless, there is a solution. This one, for instance. So we can construct our new dice, and we already know that adding up the result, we will get the same distribution as the original one. But let's check it for some value. For instance, there's only a way if you want to get 2, that is 0 plus 2. And for 12, you can obtain this number only with 7 plus 5. And you can check it by yourself, the others. An amazing solution. Absolutely wonderful. But is this the only solution?
We not only have a solution, but thanks to this amazing bridge between dice and polynomials, we have a very powerful tool which allows us to find all the possible solutions, with as many dice as we want and as many faces as we want. For instance, this is a solution with 3 dice. We challenge you to find all the possible ones and let us know in the comments what you find. If you like this problem, we have another challenge for you. Try to find 2 dice, such that when you roll them and when you add the results together, you get all the numbers from 1 to 12, all with the same frequencies. That's all for today. Thank you for staying with us. From Riccardo and Davide of MATH-segnale, ciao!